Hello, and in this video, I'm building a train viaduct. Now, this was a pretty much spur-of-the-moment build, because on the Discord, I noticed that Armesto had released some new train viaduct props, and I thought I'd give it a go at building a train viaduct. Now, he posted a really nice image that he made in his city of using the viaduct, and it was just a straight line, so I thought I'd go for the more difficult curved viaduct. Actually, it wasn't that hard. You can see here, I'm starting to place the props out in a line, and then I go through and tweak the orientation of them all. I realized that was a silly idea. Why don't I just use the prop line tool? And I end up using the prop line tool to make a curved line out of all these viaduct props. And as you can see there, the bridge actually wasn't the right height either. I thought I'd made it perfectly level, but I hadn't. It's very hard to judge things by eye. I also really wanted to use Jeren's new better than vanilla railway tracks, but as you can see, the cables are blue. And I couldn't have that. I couldn't have blue cables. So I had to just stick with the vanilla ones, which are a bit of a shame because the vanilla ones are, well, terrible in comparison. But at least they don't have a blue cable above them. I'm not sure why the cable is there. I asked Jeren and he said, they're not there for me. And that's all I got from him. So I just had to stick to vanilla, which is a bit of a shame. So as you can see here, I've drawn out the viaduct in the same shape, and I'm going to place it down as level as I can with the previous ones I've already started. And as you can see, the viaduct is way off. It's way too low. It's crazy how off it was. So my basic idea for this viaduct was, in the start, it was going to be a more modern style build, but then I realized I had some older trains running, some steam locomotives and stuff, and I felt like this build would be much more fitting for like 1910 to 1930s, and that's the sort of style I went with. That's why there is a Zeppelin in the background. I was gonna have more old cars, but it was really hard to get cars over to this area, even though I installed a like a vintage cars pack. None came over here, so all you really got was the Zeppelin in the background, showing that it was a more older style build. And while I was building this, I was thinking it would be nice to make a like a 1920s style like build, but I don't think the assets are there, which is a bit of a shame. If they ever do get there, I will make them. And by the way, the Zeppelin is made by Armesto as well. He makes a ton of great stuff. So the viaducts were not tall enough for this, so what I had to do was use some of the other props that came with the viaduct to make it taller and make it fit so that it wasn't floating in the sky. I didn't really know where I was going with this build. I wanted to leave it with no river running underneath and just have a road and trees and bushes, but it just felt bare and empty, so we skipped ahead and I have added a river and a ton of rocks and trees. Now, I didn't record it because I honestly didn't think I was going to keep the river, and then half an hour later I realized I wasn't recording. So basically all I've done is put a river down, put some river decals down in the river, which are Byronyx, and now I'm adding loads of other decals, like these dirt decals, to the banks and to the sort of off-roads and stuff to make it more like just more stuff there, because I find it really hard in City Skylines to build in open spaces. The game just isn't really made for that, I guess. Some people are really good at doing open spaces and nature. I'm not that good at it. I'm okay at best, but this is probably one of the more open builds I've done. And I sort of countered the openness by adding a ton of rocks and a ton of trees in patches, and also using Surface Painter and ore. Like, because the pack, the theme I'm using has different ore and fertilized colors, so you can paint those down in areas to affect the how they look. So that's what I've done on the edges of hills, and like in the valleys it's more lush, and on steeper slopes there's more of a color variant. Now I just placed that castle before, and it just looked a bit weird in the place I placed it, but then I placed it up here on these rocks and it actually looks okay, and it's in a fairly strategical place. It's on a hill in guarding the valley entrance. So, a fairly reasonable place for it to be. The only real thing is that I've just realised is there's a big rock next to it, and that rock would be a good place to hide behind if you were attacking the castle. So maybe I should have put more fortifications around that big rock. But I only really placed that rock to sort of fill out the area to make it look more... make this place look more realistic. Now, I don't really know where this place is. The whole time when I was thinking this, I was thinking England, maybe. But it's probably either going to be England or somewhere in Europe. Germany, France, maybe. Who knows? It's just really, all the assets are a mix of different things. So it's very hard to get a general sense of where this is and what is going on within it. So this was a very short video. I hope you enjoyed, and I'll see you next time.
Believe me. train, we get into a fight, and he falls off. Cops ask me why I did a thing like that. I tell them why. For 3 hours, I tell them why. They don't believe me.